Okay, so today we're going to be doing salt solutions or specific gravity. We are going to start with our stock solution. Our lovely stock room has provided us a 1 molar solution to start from. So I'm going to pour some of that 1 molar solution into my starting beaker so I can pull from it. We're going to be making three dilutions from our stock solution. We're going to be doing what's called a serial dilution, meaning we are taking from the previous dilution. So the first one is our stock solution, which is our 1 molar. So we're going to take our 50 milliliters from our 1 molar solution to make our first dilution of 0.5 molar. So the way we do that is we use our 50 mil pipette, which again is our most accurate of the glassware. Remember, as we talked about in the glassware, you may have to re-squeeze your bulb in order to actually get past the marking. Then, if you go too far down, you're gonna re-squeeze your bulb until you make it to the line. So now the bottom of my meniscus is on that indicating line, and we release into our 100 mil volumetric flask. Make sure to release all of it into that volumetric flask. So that is a time consuming thing. Once it is all released into the volumetric flask, you are going to fill the rest of the way to the line with DI water. This is called a dilution. You always add your stock solution first before adding your water, because the water is what's going to create the rest of your volume that you need. So we've added our 50 mils of our stock solution. Now we're gonna go ahead and add 50 mils roughly of water, but we don't know that for sure, so we just want to go ahead and add it to the line. So we use a funnel to really add the water we want. Be careful, I always stop when it reaches the neck so I don't overfill it, because as you see, some of the water actually fills into the funnel and we don't want to overfill. So I've reached the neck, so I'm going to go ahead and stop that. And then you can either use a pipette or you can just use the tip of the squirt bottle. And you're adding water until the bottom of the meniscus reaches the indicating line, which is there. So now we've made our 0.5 molar solution. You're going to dump that into your beaker right next to the one. You can use a piece of paper to indicate which of your solutions is the correct one. So I would have a piece of paper that wrote 0.5 if I wanted to, if I couldn't remember which ones are which. So now I've dumped it into my second beaker. Once you've dumped it into there, we are doing a serial dilution, meaning we're gonna take our 0.5 molar solution to make our 0.25 molar solution. If you used your 1 molar solution, you would just be making another 0.5 molar solution. So take your volumetric pipette again, squeeze, place it on top, place that in the liquid, and suction. Again, you're taking 50 mils of the 0.5 molar solution in order to make the 0.25 molar solution. So we're diluting it by half. So again, we pass that indicating mark line and release until the bottom of the meniscus is on that line, and release the solution into your volumetric flask as you did before. All has released, you are again going to take your funnel and add water to the line. Again, I only add it until it reaches the neck of the volumetric flask to prevent overfilling. Then use the squirt bottle to go the rest of the way to that line until the bottom of the meniscus is touching the line, which is there. Now you've made your 0.25 molar solution. So then I'm going to dump that into our third beaker. And we're gonna make our final solution from our 0.25 molar solution. You're gonna take, again, 50 mils of your 0.25 molar solution to make your 0.125. So same process, fill your volumetric pipette. That reach the bottom of the meniscus and dispense into your volumetric flask. Then again, we're going to fill with our water the rest of the way. And we've made our 0.125 molar solution. Now, if you were actually in lab, you would be joining up with a second group. And the reason for that is if you only used the 50 milliliters that are left in your solution, you will not be able to use your hydrometer. And I will show you why. So this is the 0.5 molar solution. Remember that when you use a hydrometer, you're going to slowly place it into the liquid, twisting as you go. The hydrometer is supposed to float. This one does not, because there's not enough liquid in that solution. So if you use the 100 mils that we do have from our 0.125 molar solution, the hydrometer will float. So that is why you would join up with a second group and use there. You would combine your 0.5 and your 0.25 solutions together so that you had 100 mils. As you twist it, it becomes buoyant and you can begin reading your meniscus and the hydrometer. So on this, you're going to read between two numbers. So a hydrometer reads to 4 decimal places. So our numbers are between 1.000 and 1.010. There are 10 tick marks between those numbers. So we are at 1.0050 and 1.0060. So we are gonna go between those two numbers and we're roughly at 1.0055. Again, you'll join with another group and measure your 0.25, 0.5, and 1 molar solutions the same way we did this one. You'll also then, once you have what is called your numbers for your calibration curve, You will then go to your two unknown solutions and measure them the same way in your graduated cylinder with your hydrometer. All of this data will be provided to you, and we'll walk you through how to create a calibration curve as well as plug in unknown values into that calibration curve.